side of the head. Return fire. Look at Taylor. Back and forth. To the eyes.
He poked him. Gave him the double barrel right to the eyes.
Yes. Oh, he hurt the knee again. He tried the atomic arm. Root. Root got it. With a Root awakening out of nowhere. And that's
it. Big win.
Schiavone, along with Jesse the Body Ventura, and the superstars of World Championship Wrestling. Just 1 week ago, Ravishing Rick Rude advances in the Nintendo Top 10 Challenge. This week, it's number 2 against number 9, and that means Ricky the Dragon Steamboat and Cactus Jack.
And this is going to be a very unorthodox match for one Mr. Steamboat. He's the number 2 contender, but he's facing number 9, the man that knows no rules, the man that don't care about nothing, Cactus Jack.
It should be a tremendous matchup, and of course, we can all just wonder about the effects of the injury about 5 weeks ago on Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. And of course, we have Medusa and Paulie and the Dangerous Alliance working on his mind as well.
Well, I'll tell you what, the tale never ends for Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. He struck a woman. Anything he gets, in my opinion, he deserves.
We are hearing comments right now from Cactus Jack and Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
Later on in this program, it's called the Top 10 match. Cactus Jack and Ricky the Dragon Steamboat to decide which one goes up and which one goes down. Look into these eyes, Steamboat! Are you afraid? You should be. But I've looked into your eyes and I feel no fear because you are not a real dragon. You see, real dragons, they breathe fire. Do you? No. After the program's over, you may not breathe at all! Bang, bang! Bang, bang!
Later in the hour, I'm going up against a 308-pound behemoth, a man that runs around crazed in this area. Bang, bang, he goes. All the wrestlers within our little niche knows that Cactus Jack has got a few screws missing, that hole in that marble bag that every once in a while you can see a steely drop out on the sidewalk. Well, Cactus Jack, later on in the hour, this dragon who's had a nose broke, who's had his family hurt, is not stepping down for you or backing up.
Okay, Ricky Steamboat and Cactus Jack both ready to go in the Nintendo Top 10 Challenge 2 versus 9 a little bit later on. And you still think Steamboat deserves all he gets? We do understand, fans, by the way, of course, coming up next week, Wrestle War, and Sting will be back in action.
Yeah, Sting will be back in action. But how much of Sting will be back in action? 50%? 70%? Certainly not, Tony, the full 100%. You don't recover that quickly.
Fans, of course, that was a very serious rib injury. Our first match in Worldwide continues right after this timeout.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following non-title match, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied by the First Lady of WCW, Medusa. He's from Hollywood, California. Weighing 253 pounds, the World Television Champion, Stunning Steve Austin. His opponent from the WCW Special Forces, one half of the Patriots, Firebreaker Ship.
Tony Schiavone, Jesse the Body Ventura, back with you here on WCW Worldwide, and Stunning Steve Austin against Firebreaker Chip. And you know, I'd like to make mention, first of all, of the World TV Champ's new look. Take a look at that hairdo.
He's looking good. You know, I'll tell you something. I'm going to take a little second opinion on the Steamboat situation.
What is that?
Medusa is hot looking. You know, I can see why the guy, you know, he probably doesn't have a happy marriage. Is particularly bored with his wife. How long's he been married now? 10, 11 years? You know, he's probably got that 7-year itch, does Steamboat.
I would agree that Medusa is hot, but I would also wonder why a lady who is hounded as she claims she is would dress that risque. Answer that one.
Dress that wouldn't risque, she looks great.
Wouldn't she dress down? Wouldn't she be like a lady?
Hey, if you got it, flaunt it, Schiavone. I mean, if you had 20-inch arms, I bet you'd wear short-sleeve shirts.
Well,
yeah, see?
Also?
Yeah, right.
When you've done the chest work in the gym she's done, you want to show it off.
An elbow to the back of the head to Firebreaker Chip. Take a look at Austin. We are 1 week away now from a Wrestle War.
You're ignoring me, Shabani.
Yes, why? You're right. You're exactly right. Arm drag takedown.
And a beautiful move there by Firebreaker Chip. He's got the TV champion down, and he's cranking the pressure on.
Well, he is.
But you notice what a distraction Medusa is. You know, this little short guy, he's over there watching her, too. He should concentrate on his wrestling.
You finish?
It's like Burgess Meredith said to Rocky and said to Stallone in the Rocky movie, women weaken legs.
A two count. Pick up. Speaking about being weak, Stunning Steve Austin is going to be part of a Wrestle War. Coming up in 1 week, he's going to be in the War Games, two rings of clothes in a cage, Jesse, and he's going to be part of the Dangerous Alliance.
That's going to be a mess. Only the strong survive in Wrestle War. A match like that, Tony, makes me happy I'm retired.
A massive crowd on hand for WCW Worldwide. It's been a massive crowd on hand each and every time Jesse Body Ventura's been here.
Did I tell you last week how I helped Jack Nicklaus on the third? I told you that.
Many times. Over the top. A pickup. Stunning Steve, the stun gun. That's his stun gun, his premier move. And he's going to win this one.
And he got him.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, the World Television Champion, Stunning Steve Austin.
He has been the World Television Champion for about 15 months now, Jesse, and that's the reason why.
And you know, it's very hard to maintain that TV title because, you know, you have to defend it so often, so I'm very impressed with Stunning Steve Austin. Here you see he's got Firebreaker Chip, boom, the stun gun. Right off the top rope, hooks the leg, rolls back. Too much for Chip, gets the three count, and Stunning Steve and Medusa with a glorious championship exit.
We take you now to Eric Bischoff in the WCW Magazine.
Whoa. I'm Eric Bischoff, and this is the WCW Magazine for the week ending May 10th, 1992. Well, we're just 1 week away from the opening bell at Wrestle War 92 and War Games. And without a doubt, the topic of conversation in wrestling circles around the country is the injury to the WCW World's Heavyweight Champion, Sting. Recently, I had the opportunity to visit with the champion in his home, and I got these comments.
In your condition, how exactly are you feeling right now?
Well, let me just start off by saying I appreciate your concern. I appreciate everybody's concern out there watching, but what we're talking about is something pretty simple, really, in that I have a broken rib. I'll be back. I promise I'll be back. And I've said it before, and I'll say it again, stick with me and don't give up on me yet.
Is Sting taking his injury too lightly? It's understandable that the WCW World's Heavyweight Champion would not want to reveal the extent of his injury at this time. After all, Sting is certainly going to be a marked man once he steps inside the two-ring steel cage at War Games. And Paulie Dangerously has made it abundantly clear the lengths to which he's going to go to destroy anything that stands between himself and total control of World Championship Wrestling. And War Games could provide Dangerously with the ideal opportunity to eliminate Sting from WCW permanently. Contact your local cable company and order Wrestle War 92 exclusively on pay-per-view May 17th. I'm Eric Bischoff, and I'll be back later on in the hour with another Wrestle War 92 update.
Following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied by the Chief Executive Officer of the Dangerous Alliance, Paul E. Dangerously. He's from Huntsville, Alabama, weighing 233 pounds. Beautiful Bobby!
You know why he doesn't have the belt on, don't you?
Why?
We have new World Tag Team Champions, Hardy Har Har Har. Scott and Rick Steiner won the World Tag Team belts 1 week ago in Chicago. And that's not a nice look on Bobby's face.
Well, one thing we know, whether the Steiners are the greatest wrestling champions, we won't know, but we do know they're the ugliest champions.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent from Austin, Texas, weighing 261 pounds, the natural Dustin Rhodes.
Dustin Rhodes, one-on-one against beautiful Bobby, and what an ovation for the youngster from Austin, Texas. Yes, the Steiners became World Tag Team Champs. They'll have an interview for us coming up immediately following the break. But right now, a match that will certainly be a main event anywhere. That's an overused term, but it really applies here because we got two of the best.
Who's interviewing? Coming up, the Steiners?
Yeah, we're going to have the Steiners and some comments they had earlier this week.
Who's interpreting for them?
I don't. Nobody's interpreting. You make me say things out here I would normally never say, you know?
I do have that impact on people, yeah. Don't I, Shimani?
Impact is the key word here. Dustin, for a youngster, is always so focused, so intense. And Bobby certainly has many more years of experience than Dustin does. Bobby's going to try to take it his own way here.
Well, beautiful Bobby is giving up a leverage advantage and quite a bit of weight and height, both do. The young natural Dustin Rhodes. This should be a great matchup here. Ooh, look at that.
Back. Beautiful Bobby. That's what you call getting the taste slapped out of your mouth, so to speak. And Dustin still very focused on the beautiful Bobby. Of course, Dustin Rhodes and Ricky Steamboat were World Tag Team Champions at one time.
Yeah, for about a week and a half.
No, that's not true. Arn and Bobby won the belts from them, and then the Steiners come and capture the titles in Chicago. Congratulations to the Steiners, and a hello to all of our great fans that watch us on WGBO each and every week in Chicago. Big elbow! And again! Again!
Whoa!
Back and forth it goes!
Whoa! Caught him with the right hand and put him all the way over the top. Look at Paul Lee calling timeout. He's saying disqualify him for firing him over the top rope. You know, in a way, though, the Steiners as tag team champions should be a great influence on children, you know? It proves that you can be illiterate today and still go to college.
It belongs to you. Forget about what I said. Forget it.
Oh, my, I'm sorry.
You know, it proves, Shimani, you don't have to study in high school. You don't have to study in grade school. Just be a big meatball specialist, and they'll take you up at Michigan, and they'll pass the test for you.
That is not true,
Can you imagine Bo Schembechler taking their civics test for him or the history exam?
Fans, do not write to me at WCW for comments that Jesse the Body Ventura makes. Please. Full arm drag and twist. Down goes beautiful Bobby and Dustin now.
Now that's just out and out mean right there, Shimani. He could break his arm with that move.
And so what's wrong with that? You think that the Dangerous Lions will not try to break his arm next week in WrestleWar?
I didn't say there was nothing wrong with it. I just said it was outright mean. There's a lot of meanness in this Dustin Rhodes. You know, he's not just some string bean Texican from Austin.
Texan.
That's what I said, Texican.
Two count. Bobby trying to get up, and Dustin holding him right down.
He's got him hooked pretty good in there. Beautiful Bobby's got the hammer lock underneath him, and Bobby goes to the eyes. That's one thing you can always do, no matter how tough the hold is. You can go to the guy's eyes and get out of it.
That's exactly right. It draws some boos from the fans, but Bobby has heard boos enough in his career. Here he goes!
Ooh.
He got him in the back with a knee that time. It drove him right out. Look at him holding his back there.
Well, if Dustin had a kidney stone, it's passed by now.
Look at this. He tried to go head first.
Now that's true.
You know what that is? The referee had his back turned. That would be an automatic disqualification now in World Championship Wrestling. Ahead to the ring post. Kay Allen Fry, a couple of weeks ago on one of our television programs, told us so. And the fight goes outside.
Yeah, but it'll be interesting to see whether Kay Allen Fry truly enforces those rules. You know, I found that Kay Allen Fry plays a lot of favorites.
Yeah, I have too.
And to me, let's ask the question, will he enforce the rules if one of his favorite wrestlers does it to somebody? Will he do it? That's the question.
Beautiful Bobby. Whoa! On the arm.
course, if the Steiners did it, they could always claim ignorance to the law.
Working on the arm again, beautiful Bobby.
And sinking in that short arm scissors. There's a move you don't see much today in wrestling. That's a wear down move right there.
And there's a move you see a lot of with the dangerous lines throughout. The illegal advantage, thanks to Paulie.
But you notice how smart Paulie was. The referee digging in, looking for a three count. He cannot see Paulie.
I never said he was dumb. He is anything but dumb. A man who splits his time between the telephone and the wrestling ring.
Has Paulie ever taken you to lunch?
No, he hasn't.
Figured. You better clean your lifestyle up, Shivani.
Referee in there again. We have a tremendous match going on, and there's the illegal advantage one more time.
And look how Paulie gets away from the rope. Ref sees nothing. I love it.
You know, Paulie's not going to be able to do that in WrestleWar. Those guys will be in the cage. He's going to be out there screaming like a banshee. I know how Paulie gets when he's upset. Yeah,
I did it.
You sure did.
I did it. Excuse me.
He admits it. Look at
something.
Oh, he got caught. He got caught.
Good. Good. Here we go. Oh, yeah. Whoa. You're talking about right hands. He's had enough. He ducks. Does Dustin. Caught him. Atomic drop. Head of steam. He's got it.
He could get it.
No. Not at all. Drop kick. Dustin Rhodes with a cover. We've got two. And Bobby's out of it one more time. Giving it. They're all this week on WCW Worldwide. What a match. Elbow. Dustin goes down. Bobby goes out. Both men are down. Bobby quickly popped back up.
And I think beautiful Bobby, if he can get his marbles together, is going to try to go to the top here. I don't know if this is smart or not.
He's up top.
He got caught.
Bulldog! Look at Paulie! Somebody count right now!
Paulie's got the...
Wait a minute! That's the Diamond Stud! The Diamond Stud out of nowhere! On to Dustin!
Ho-ho!
Dustin's up!
One, two, oh!
No!
We've just had a grand theft take place here, Shivani.
As you know, very excited that the Steiners are World Tag Team Champions once again. Let's hear these pre-recorded comments from the new Tag Team Champs of the World.
World Tag Team Champions, Arn Anderson, Bob Eaton, a good team. But I knew sooner or later, me and my brother come around. You see, my brother's taking him a long time to get back here. You see, he hurt his arm doing whatever he had to do to get back. Bob Eaton, Arn Anderson, Dangerous Alliance, he did a lot of things. Trip us up. Sooner or later, what goes around comes around, and me and my brother came around and got these.
Beautiful Bobby and Arn Anderson, you guys are a great team. But I said it once, I'd said it 1,000 times. We were going back up to the top. You know, last summer,
we're at the top of the heap.
When I got hurt, it took me a long road back. But I want to thank the fans that believed in me and my brother, and not you, Bobby and Arn, because you guys are a bunch of cheaters, and you never beat us in the first place. So we're at the top. I don't care where we wrestle, Japan, Europe, or in our own United States, we're going to be on top for a long time.
You see, when it comes right down to it, Bob Eaton, Arn Anderson, you want a rematch? We'll give you a rematch. Any other tag teams out there want to come and try it? Come and try it. Me and my brother never back down from nobody. Got no reason to. You see, when we get in the ring, pain, abuse, physical punishment, we're the World Tag Team Champion.
And we're on top. And you got to come to us to wrestle us. When you wrestle us, you're in our world. And if you're not us, it's not a fun place to be.
Wrestling fans, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied by JT Southern, he's from Palm Beach, Florida, weighing 228 pounds, Scotty Flamingo. His opponent from Seattle, Washington, 238 pounds, John Peterson.
Scotty Flamingo, John Peterson, and I know the look right there from Scotty Flamingo. He's a man who feels that the women are privileged just to be able to touch his body.
Well, you know, they could do a lot worse than him. The kid's loaded with money. His mom and dad are loaded. He's never worked a day in his life. Great-looking athlete.
And a graduate with a couple of degrees from the University of Miami. Now, we just saw some graduates from Michigan, the Steiners, the World Tag Team Champions. What are you laughing at?
They really graduated?
Of course they did.
They did. Of course they did. In other words, they could produce that sheepskin.
Yes.
Let me ask you this then, Shivani.
Okay.
What did the Steiners get their degrees in?
Don't
you dare tell me chemical engineering and advanced nuclear physics.
I don't know what it's. I think Rick may have a degree in history.
I think Rick got it in dog grooming, if I'm not mistaken. And I don't mean being a vet either.
Take a look at Scotty Flamingo, a guy you interviewed just last week right here. Very cocky, very confident. He says he'll be the next light heavyweight champion. But Flying Brian needs to look ahead to his close friend, the Z-Man. They go one-on-one in a wrestling war in 1 week.
Well, I'll tell you what, we're getting such a massive amount of light heavies that we may soon have a Nintendo light heavyweight tournament.
Yeah.
With 1 through 10 battling it out, because the light heavies are coming out of the woodwork, and it's great to see in the world of wrestling. You know, because for many years, if you take a look at boxing, boxing was dead without the likes of a Sugar Ray Leonard or a Marvin Hagler.
Well, yeah.
Who were the lighter weights. And I'm happy to see that happening now in the world of wrestling. More than just the big heavyweights, you get the smaller man. He's getting his day in the sun.
Sometimes you make a lot of sense, you know? Sometimes you do.
All the time I make a lot of sense. You know, and it gets guys like with short men complexes like Chip the Firebreaker, you know, they can get out and wrestle then instead of walking around with a grudge all the time because they're short.
There's his pile driver, and that should be it for Peterson. That is it.
And quite a casual cover there by Scotty Flamingo.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, Scotty Flamingo.
Okay, Eric Bischoff standing by the WCW magazine, and then we're going to go to a special word from one of our superstars. And what is the meaning of this?
I guess that's called an additional pile driver on. Now what?
Johnny B. Badd, one of the great light heavyweights. Oh, he knocks down JT Southern. He's had enough of this. He's gonna go out with Scotty Flamingo.
Now what's the purpose of this? Little Richard had nothing to do with this bout. What's he doing coming out?
That's Johnny B. Badd, Jesse. He wants him right now. Two of the great light heavyweights almost coming to blows here on WCW Worldwide. All right, let's go to the magazine with Eric.
I'm Eric Bischoff with another edition of the WCW Magazine. Earlier on in the hour, we heard from the WCW World's Heavyweight Champion, who has assured his fans that he will be ready for War Games despite his recent injury. But what about the other members of Sting's team? Given the danger that War Games presents to both teams, physical as well as mental preparation are keys to survival. And to sabotage Sting's team going into War Games, the Dangerous Alliance has been waging its own twisted form of psychological warfare on Ricky Steamboat. Paul E. Dangerously and Medusa have accused Ricky Steamboat of having a fixation on the self-proclaimed First Lady of World Championship Wrestling. But as you're about to see, that strategy may have backfired on the Dangerous Alliance.
We have to deal with one lustful Ricky the Dragon Steamboat who is literally upsetting this beautiful woman. Not only did he strike her, he is now sexually harassing her.
You know, Jesse the Body Ventura, it's no secret around the locker room that Medusa walks on the ground that Ricky Steamboat worships. But Ricky Steamboat You two-timing lecherous pervert! Let me tell you this on behalf of the Dangerous Alliance one final time. Stay the hell away from Medusa!
Paul E. Dangerously and Medusa to the Dragon's surprising and heated display was quite obvious. What wasn't so obvious was Steamboat's motives. Now, was Ricky Steamboat fighting fire with his own brand of mind over matter? Or was it something more? Nobody wants to believe the accusations coming from Medusa and Paul E. Dangerously, but as the saying goes, where there's smoke, there's fire. And before we close this edition of the WCW Magazine, rumors have it that Harley Race, the former seven-time world heavyweight champion, has added another dimension to his arsenal. It's been reported that Race has acquired the services of the Super Invader. And after what Van Vader did to Sting a few weeks ago, if these rumors are true and the Super Invader is making his way to World Championship Wrestling, I think it's a safe bet that finishing the job Van Vader started will be first on the Super Invader's agenda.
It's decision time for all you young athletes. Take steroids or not to take them. Well, let me tell you something. I talk from experience. I've seen throughout my career what steroids can do. I've seen the record bench presses. But unfortunately, I've seen the injuries. I've seen the illnesses. And I've seen the heartbreak and despair when a young athlete and his family has to go through a career-ending suspension thanks to steroids. Make the right decision. Don't do steroids.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Nevada, weighing 307 pounds, Benny Vegas.
There he is, the Leisure Ship King of the 90s.
Looks like a monster, don't he?
Ladies and gentlemen, his opponent from Dallas, Texas, 232 pounds, Randy Starr.
Randy Starr is going to go up against 6'10", 6'10", Vinny Vegas.
You know what's kind of interesting? You know, Kopeski or whatever his name is, the ring announcer.
Capetta.
Whatever. He says, from Nevada. Well, where do you think Vinny Vegas would be from? Podunk, Arkansas?
No. Gary just announces what is written, what he's told. You think he should say, well, obviously from Nevada, you think he should become another smart aleck announcer? Don't you think we have enough of those in this
sport? No, but I mean, with a name like Vinny Vegas, like I said, he ain't from Podunk, Arkansas.
But he is very effective. Take a look at Vinny Vegas and look at those suspenders for crying out loud. Wonder if the suspenders and if that tie would be just like the lining of his coat, the same material. I think that would.
I imagine. Well, at least he's not wearing the passionate pink this week.
Yeah. What's he doing? What was that?
I'm not sure.
It's almost like he took out a gun in his holster and shot a hole through his head or something. All right, this is called the Snake Eyes.
Snake Eyes. He's going to roll Snake Eyes here.
It's an awesome move.
Or if you're the opponent, it's the craps.
Yeah, I guess that's what it is.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner.
See the opponents
Vinny
on the ground right now
Vegas.
Going on.
Yes.
Okay, Vinny Vegas gets a win right here on WCW Worldwide. The big guy at 6'10", becoming quite a power. Coming up next, though, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat will go up one-on-one against Cactus Jack. And you're going to get to talk to Paulie Dangerously right here, the executive of the Dangerous Alliance.
And I always enjoy that because you know what? The first time I first came to WCW, Paulie Dangerously was the only guy that took me out to lunch and paid for it. I've bought your lunch four times now, Shivani.
I thought it was three times. Where's the fourth? Well, maybe so, but Cactus Jack and Ricky Steamboat coming up next in our Nintendo Top 10 Challenge.
And I'm pumped up for that one because Cactus Jack, you don't know. The fight could be on the floor. It could be all the way out in the parking lot by the time Cactus Jack is done. Dragon, you better watch out because the Dangerous Alliance will be lurking in the shadows.
The winner advances in the Nintendo Top 10 Challenge. We'll be back on WCW Worldwide right after this.
Well, here I am with my favorite man, the CEO of the Dangerous Alliance, Paulie Dangerously. Paul, only you can appreciate it. Here we are in Augusta, Georgia, the home of the Masters Golf Tournament, and only you can appreciate that Fred Couples said that I, reading the greens for him, led him to victory here in the Masters.
You know, I've known Fred Couples a long, long time, and he's a man that never lies. And I not only heard that, Jesse the Body Ventura, I read that on the front page of the sports section of the New York Times this morning.
Absolutely. Now, I'd love to chew the fat with you, Paul, and talk about some good things. But unfortunately, we are not in that position right now.
No.
Because of a certain Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
Oh, you see, Jesse the Body Ventura, it goes a lot further and deeper than that. See, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat is but part of a conspiracy against the Dangerous Alliance, and that conspiracy is being headed by K. Allen Fry. You see, Mr. Fry, your future is about as bright as Mike Tyson's, and I'm going to tell you why right now. You slanted the odds in the favor of the Steiner brothers against Bobby and Arn. You're allowing Ricky the Dragon Steamboat to criminally harass the First Lady of Wrestling, Medusa. You've taken away my job. You take away my danger zone. And you have single-handedly tried to destroy the Dangerous Alliance. Well, let me inform you of something, you jerk. I am the CEO of the most lethal group of individuals in the history of World Championship Wrestling. And just like when a volcano erupts and the lava, the molten lava, drips down the side of that mountain, we're red hot and we're out of control. And by the time I'm done with you, K. Allen Fry, you're going to be so damn out of work that you'll be begging myself and Jesse the Body for a miserable, stinking job.
You can't say much more than that. Up to you, Gary Kapiski, into the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, our special top 10 match. It is set for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. Introducing first, he's the number 9 contender for the World Heavyweight Championship. From Truth or Consequences, New Mexico, weighing 302 pounds, Cactus Jack.
Bang, bang!
Shivani, he graduated from Michigan, too.
Let's go back to Gary Capetta.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent. He is the number 2 contender for the World Heavyweight Championship. He is from Charlotte, North Carolina. He weighs 241 pounds. Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
Full of fire and vigor, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat against Cactus Jack.
You know, it's interesting. How long's he been wearing this face shield now? 5 weeks? Now, give me a break. Charles Barkley in the NBA broke his nose. He had to wear one of those. He had it on for about 10 or 12 days. Now, how is it Steamboat's got to wear this thing for 5 weeks?
Because Steamboat wrestles and Barkley plays basketball. That's why. Simple answer. Look at that. Directed right towards ravishing Rick Rude.
I think you better worry about Cactus Jack not ravishing Rick Rude right now.
The winner of this match will go on in our Nintendo Top 10 Challenge. We'll advance. And I can bet you right now. Here's just a guess. A lot of guessing, a lot of hypothetical things are going on in WCW. Just ask the Dangerous Alliance. Ask Paul Lee Dangerous. I bet you Cactus Jack is not here to win a match. I bet he's here on behalf of Paul Lee to further injure the Snows. He's a mercenary. He's never been a man to win matches.
That's a lot of speculation on your part, Shabani.
Well, we've had a lot of it today. Just ask Paul Lee Dangerous. You interviewed him.
Yeah, and Paul Lee says the problem is K. Allen Fry. Whoa, that was a DDT, right?
Out of nowhere, it should be over. And Cactus Jack came out of a DDT. I guess if you try to hurt his hand, you're not going to get much success. There's a two count. Steamboat got him again.
Well, the thing with Cactus Jack is you can stun him, but you can't really hurt him. The guy loves pain.
Steamboat's on him again for a two count. Steamboat continues to come close to getting these wins. A good shot of the Dragon. That padded nose brace of his. Cactus went right to the face. He's going right after the nose. There you go.
Yeah, but he can't hurt him, see? He's got that protective shield on there. A normal guy would have caught it right on the bridge of the nose and been down flat on his back. Instead, Steamboat's out there with a protective device. It doesn't hurt him, and therefore he catches Cactus in an arm drag takedown.
That's why.
That is called unfair advantage due to equipment.
I'm not gonna sit here and argue with you.
It's just like in golf, which I know all about. Remember the big controversy on square grooves? You can spin the ball more. That's unfair advantage due to equipment. And I found out, Shabani, you play pings, don't you?
Yeah.
You cheater, you.
There's a drop kick. Over the top. That should be a disqualification.
No, he didn't go over. You got to hit the floor.
Yeah, you're right.
He never hit the floor. Now he did.
Now what are we going to do here? The match will continue, and Mike Atkins administering the 10 count.
Well, I guess he figures since they both went out over the top, he don't want to throw them both out of the match, although that can happen in this top 10 tournament. If you don't win, you don't advance. If it's a draw, you're out of it. If you're disqualified, you're out of it.
That's right. A hook. Roddy Man, a running suplex attack. May have him here. Steamboat gets the left shoulder up just in time.
You know what the scary thing about Cactus Jack is? Not only is he crazy, but at times he can wrestle. You know, the guy's got some pretty fair moves in there.
You're right. Again.
Shabani, I'm always right. Why question me?
Next week, I get to interview Ricky the Dragon Steamboat right here on WCW Raw.
Oh, what a pleasure that ought to be. Well, I'll tell you what. Since you're going to interview him, ask him a question right from me.
All right.
Why he, a married man, is lusting after Medusa.
See, you're not always right. Side headlock. Cactus Jack picked up by Steamboat. Belly to back out of nowhere.
You won't ask him, will you?
No. That's an opinionated question.
Opinionated? All I need is a yes or a no.
Why don't you ask him yourself?
You won't interview with me.
Kicked to the chest. Steamboat.
Steamboat's a kind of...
Jesse, that time, Cactus Jack went right after the nose again. All of his weight centered on the face. And he missed. He hit the ring bell. Steamboat. There's his mark. Two.
He got it.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
Steamboat advances in the top 10 challenge. And yes, broken nose and all, he's ready for ravishing Rick Rude.
There you see the Dragon off the top with the patented crossbody. Catches Cactus Jack. Momentum almost carries him over. Manages to hook the leg. Gets the three count and a big win for the Dragon.
I'm Eric Bischoff with this final edition of the WCW Magazine. Well, last Sunday on the main event, WCW Executive Vice President K. Allen Fry announced that World Championship Wrestling had been granted the rights to the NWA Tag Team Tournament.
I'm pleased to announce that after several months of negotiations, WCW has obtained worldwide television rights to the upcoming National Wrestling Alliance World Tag Tournament. World Championship Wrestling is proud to play a role in the resurgence of the NWA, a truly historic international alliance of wrestling promoters.
The first round of the tournament will take place Tuesday, June 16th at the Clash of the Champions, and we'll see some of the top tag team combinations in the world competing for the NWA Tag Team Crown. Now, the NWA has named the top 8 seeds in this invitational tournament. They include the Steiner Brothers in the number 1 position, the Japanese team of Hase and Akira seated number 2, Arn Anderson and beautiful Bobby Eaton hold the number 3 seed, Dr. Death, Steve Williams, and Terry Bam Bam Gordy are the number 4 seed. The Mexican representatives of the Silver King 1 and 2 hold the number 5 seed, and Ravishing Rick Rude and Stunning Steve Austin won the number 6 position. The Malenkos hold the number 7 seed, representing the European contingent, and the Canadian team of Chris Benoit and Beef Wellington hold the 8th and final seed in the tournament. The quarter, semi, and final rounds of this exciting event will take place at the Great American Bash on July 12th in Philadelphia.
Nikita, you're in for the ride of your life. I thought you were a reasonably intelligent man. You walk in the ring with this guy on the top 10 challenge next week. You're in for the ride of your life for pain, buddy, like you've never experienced.
Next week, and does your challenge? I'm talking about the top 10 challenge. Nikita Koloff and Big Van Vader. I'm going to be ready, Van Vader. I hope you are ready.
It's going to resemble more of a grudge match next week. Nikita Koloff and Big Van Vader, the winner to advance.
Big Van Vader is the most awesome destruction machine I have seen in WCW. If I was Nikita, I'd get on the fast boat back to Lithuania quick.
All right, fans, that'll be next week. And, of course, next week we're 1 week away from WrestleWar.
Absolutely. Jacksonville, Florida, the 17th. The body comes back to Florida.
We'll see you next week right here on WCW Worldwide.